Welcome to my study channel. Friends, our today's topic is CTAT pedagogy questions. These questions have been taken from Piaget, Kohlberg and Vygotsky theories of development. This is our second part of this video and these questions have been repeated in previous exams. If we see, these questions were repeated in Feb 2015, September 2015, Feb 2016 and September 2016 exams. So, friends, please give focus on these questions. Try to revise these questions 2 or 3 times so that you might be able to tick the right option in your exams. So, without wasting time, let's start from question number 1. Question number 1 is, according to Vygotsky, zone of proximal development is dash. This question was repeated in Feb 2015 exam. So, the options are zone demarcating the spot offered by the teacher. Second option is what the teacher can do on her own which cannot be assessed. Third option is the gap between what the child can do independently and with assistance. And fourth option is the amount and nature of support provided to the child to achieve her potential. Friends, here option 3 is the right answer. That is the gap between what the child can do independently and with assistance. Let's repeat the question. According to Vygotsky, zone of proximal development is the gap between what the child can do independently and with assistance. So, let's move to question number 2. Question number 2 is, according to Piaget's theory, children learn by dash. Here, option 4 is the right answer, that is processes of adaptation. According to Piaget's theory, children learn by processes of adaptation. Let's move to question number 3. Question number 3 is, Piaget proposes that pre-operational children are unable to conserve. He attributes this inability to which one of the following factors? Let's revise the question. Piaget proposes that pre-operational children are unable to conserve. He attributes this inability to which one of the following factors? Option 1 is inability of hypothetical deductive reasoning. Second is lack of high-level abstract reasoning. And third is personal favor. Fourth one is irreversibility of thought. Friends, here option 4 is the right answer, that is irreversibility of thought. Question number 3 is, what is the major criticism of Kohlberg's theory? This is also most important question. What is the major criticism of Kohlberg's theory? Option 1 is, Kohlberg proposed a theory without any empirical basis. So, second option is, Kohlberg did not give clear-cut stages of moral development. Third one is, Kohlberg proposed that moral reasoning is development. And fourth one is, Kohlberg did not account for cultural differences in moral reasoning of men and women. Friends, here option 4 is the right answer. What is the major criticism of Kohlberg's theory? So, the right answer is option 4, that is, Kohlberg did not account for cultural differences in moral reasoning of men and women. Question number 4 is, which of the following statement best summarizes the relationship between development and learning as proposed by Vygotsky? Friends, here option 1 is, development is independent of learning. Second is, learning and development are parallel processes. And third one is, development process lags behind the learning process. And fourth one is, development is synonymous with learning. Friends, here option 3 is the right answer, that is, development process lags behind the learning process. Which of the following statement best summarizes the relationship between development and learning as proposed by Vygotsky? Option 3 is the right answer, that is, development process lags behind the learning process. Let's move to question number 5. A major difference between the perspectives of Vygotsky and Piaget pertains to dash. Here option 1 is, their critique of behavioristic principles. Second is, their conception of children as active constructors of knowledge. And third is, the role of providing a nurturing environment to children. And fourth one is, their views about language and thought. So, friends, option 4 is the right answer. A major difference between the perspectives of Vygotsky and Piaget pertains to their views about language and thought. Question number 6 is, the amount of type of scaffolding to a child would change depending on the dash. The amount of type of scaffolding to a child would change depending on the dash. Here option 4 is the right answer, that is, level of child's performance. So, So, the amount of type of scaffolding to a child would change depending on the level of the child's performance. Question number 7 is, what term oblique phrase does Piaget use for mental structure which are the building block of thinking? This question was repeated in September 2015 exam. So, here option 3 is the right answer, that is schemas. What term oblique phrase does Piaget use for mental structure which are the building block of thinking, that is schemas? Here option 1 was gene, second was maturation blocks, and third one was schemas, and fourth one was zone of development. Option 3 is the right answer, that is schemas. Let's move to next question. According to Vygotsky, why do children speak to themselves? Option 1 is, children use their speech to attract the attention of adults to them. Second is, children are very talkative by nature. Third is, children use speech to guide their actions. And fourth one is, children are egocentric. Friends, here option 3 is the right answer, that is children use speech to guide their actions. According to Vygotsky, why do children speak to themselves? Children use speech to guide their actions. Question number 9. Development of the capacity for abstract scientific is a characteristic of, first option is concrete operational stage, second is formal operational stage, third is sensory motor stage, and fourth one is pre-operational stage. Friends, here option 2 is the right answer, that is formal operational stage. Development of the capacity for abstract scientific is a characteristic of formal operational stage. I repeat the question. Development of the capacity for abstract scientific is a characteristic of formal operational stage. Question number 10 is, a child reason, you do this for me and I will do that for you. In which stage of Kohlberg moral reasoning would this child fall? Friends, the goodbye, good girl orientation. A child reason, you do this for me and I will do this for you. In which stage of Kohlberg's moral reasoning would this child fall? Option first is the right answer, that is the good boy, good girl orientation. Question number 11 is, which of the following is a good example of scaffolding learning of a problem solving task till the student is able to do it by herself? I repeat the question, which of the following is a good example of scaffolding learning of a problem solving task till the student is able to do it by herself? Option 1 is the right answer, that is providing a half solved example. Providing a half solved example. You can read the another options too. Question number 12 is, according to Piaget, which one of the following factors play an important role in influencing development? I repeat the question, according to Piaget, which one of the following factors play an important role in influence development? Option 1 is experience with the physical world, second is imitation, third one is reinforcement, and fourth one is language. So option 1 is the right answer, that is experience with the physical world. This question was repeated in Feb 2016 exam. According to Piaget, which one of the following factors play an important role in influencing development? That is option 1, experience with the physical world. Question number 13 is, the concept of private speech of children as proposed by Vygotsky. The concept of private speech of children as proposed by Vygotsky. Option 1 is, illustrates that the children use speech to guide their own actions. Second one is, shows that children love themselves. Third one is, shows that children are stupid and thus need guidance of adults. Fourth one is, illustrates that children are egocentric. Friends, here option 1 is the right answer, that is illustrates that the children use speech to guide their own actions. Question number 14 is, according to Vygotsky, learning cannot be separated from, option 1 is reinforcement, second is a measurable change in behavior, third one is perception and attention process, and fourth one is its social context. So according to Vygotsky, learning cannot be separated from its social context. Option 4 is the right answer. Question number 15 and last question of this session is, the concept of conservation as proposed by Jean Piaget means that. The concept of conservation as proposed by Jean Piaget means that. Option 1 is, certain physical properties the same even when appearances change. Option 1 is certain physical properties are same even when appearances change. Second option is it is important to protect the forests. Third one is one can arrive at the correct conclusions by systematically testing hypothesis. Fourth one is taking the perspective into consideration is an cognitive ability. Friends, here option 1 is the right answer, that is certain physical properties the same even when appearances change. So friends, today we have completed all the questions of this development theories. So I hope आपको जो है इन क्वेश्चंस की रिवीजन के साथ जो है बहुत सारी मदद मिलेगी, और मैं उम्मीद करता हूँ दैट नो क्वेश्चन विल कम फ्रॉम आउटसाइड ऑफ दीज क्वेश्चंस. सो थैंक्स फॉर वॉचिंग दिस वीडियो. प्लीज सब्सक्राइब एंड प्रेस द बेल आइकन टू गेट ऑल द लेटेस्ट वीडियोज. स्टे होम, स्टे सेफ. थैंक यू. बाय बाय.